Hey guys, what's up? This is GaLm, welcome to Far Cry 4 on the PC. I know, it's been a while since I've done a PC Let's Play, but it's gonna be alright. I was really looking forward to this. Far Cry 3 performed pretty well, and it's a first-person shooter, so I was like, you know what, out of all the games I'm gonna get this season, this has to be on PC, and I'm gonna hope that it performs pretty well. I did max out most of the settings, if I can get to it, but it defaulted to not being like that. It defaulted to high, and I had to go up very high, and then ultra high, and then I was like, well, that's still not everything maxed out, so I hope it's not trying to say something about my system. I have a 780 Ti, so it's not like I have a really out-of-date card or anything like that. It should be fantastic. But we'll see. I did play a little bit of the multiplayer to try and see what my performance would be like, but I didn't have ambient occlusion on, and I didn't have anti-aliasing on TXAA, and I didn't have God Rays enhanced. So again, we don't know, like, we'll have to see. I do have Fraps open, so I can look at my FPS when we get in game, but we're not gonna worry about that. Let's get into talking about stuff. So I'm pretty hyped up about this. A lot of reviews have come out that are kind of praising it. I haven't looked at them because I don't really want any spoilers, but at the very least I heard that the game performs pretty well, and that's a godsend considering that in this gaming season we are getting disappointments and broken games left and right, and holy shit, it doesn't make any sense at all. But I have faith. I have faith in the Far Cry team because Far Cry 3 was pretty damn good. The only problems I had with Far Cry 3 were the story kind of, like, it had a plot and then it forgot that it should have a good plot because it was like, I don't know what to do. Just send them in the world and let them skin animals, okay? That's all they had to do. And they're right, I was okay with that, but fucking, like, they had an awesome villain, they did nothing with him, they had okay villains, they did nothing with them. It didn't make sense at all how that ended up happening. Especially with all the effort they took to make Voss seem like some super awesome, hyped up dude. You figured he'd be, like, making it all the way to the end of the game. He doesn't even make it one third through the game. Spoilers. But yeah, no, Far Cry 3 is pretty good. And hopefully they learn their lessons. Things like, you know, if you conquer an outpost and you're at the end of the game with no enemies to kill, that sucks. So hopefully they do something like, oh, enemies can try and capture it back, or they made it more in depth, things like that. But I guess we will have to see as we start a new game. Now I'm going to put it on hard because normal, I believe we played Far Cry 3 on normal and it was mega super easy. So we're just gonna put on, we're gonna put the game on hard. We're gonna hope for the best, and if it's too hard, then tough tits to me. I can adapt, don't worry. No, we are not playing this in co-op. We are playing it offline where it is the best experience because you don't have to worry about someone else kind of interrupting you and talking over cutscenes and stuff like that. Unless you're the one talking over the cutscenes, then you don't have to worry about yourself. I mean, you guys are the ones watching me, so actually, I'm that guy! Fuck. Oh well, we're doing it offline. After you break through into Northern Kyrat, powerful new weapons and skills will be unlocked. Well, that's spoilers, isn't it? Amita values progress. Stop spoiling things for me, game! You don't have to tell me tips before I'm even loaded in. Obviously, we've already seen the beginning of the game through E3. We know about the main villain, who's Pagan Min, who's basically Troy Baker, if they said, hey, be about a little bit crazy. And he's like, okay, I'll do that. And so I'm looking forward to that. I love Troy Baker. Not in the love way, but just I enjoy all of his roles. Unless you're Call of Duty and you manage to ruin Troy Baker somehow.
Mr. Gale, this is Chet Peterson from the U.S. Embassy here in Patna. I'm calling you pursuant to the application for a tourist visa for India with further travel to Kyrat. We can only accept your status as a U.S. citizen as we have no official records regarding your Kyrati citizenship. Furthermore, I must legally advise you against traveling into Kyrat. We have no official diplomatic presence in Kyrat due to the civil unrest with the Golden Path. In regards to your intent to bring with you the cremated remains of one Ishwari Gale, you'll need to bring with you the passport for the deceased.
Hey. Passport.
What's happening?
Oh shit.
Stop, shoot. Do those words sound insane?
That it got out of control?
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. What'd you say?
It got out of control.
Got out of control. I hate when things get out of control. Oh! One fucking jab, but you couldn't fucking do that!
Maybe you shouldn't stab a dude in your nice shoes.
At least there's a silver lining. You didn't completely fuck it up. Get up, boy. I'd recognize those eyes anywhere. I'm so sorry about this. This was supposed to be... Well, not this. We have a party waiting for you. But I don't think I know your name. Who is this? Is this your plus one? Strong silent type. I like it. I am terribly embarrassed about all of this. This was supposed to be very simple, but you know, if you give food to monkeys, they just throw their shit at each other. You know. Oh, would you hold this? For just a moment, I want to get a little picture right into the camera. There we are. Awesome. Don't worry about a thing, my boy. This will soon be behind us, and we'll be off on a grand adventure. Because I have cleared my calendar for you. You and I are gonna tear shit up!
Okay, all right.
Should I stay or should I go?
I like this guy! I don't know what he means by fucking shit up, but I like him.
Will you give my congratulations to Ashley on your next visit home? I must say, Paul, your little corner of Kyrati is rather beautiful. I expected more, you know, chains and wailing, but knowing you, somewhere around here is a dark place where the secrets flow like the blood. That wry smile betrays you again, Deplur. Well, go on, take the bloody bag off his head.
Again, terribly sorry for what happened before. This is more what I had in mind. So, fresh start. Introductions. Ajay Ghale, our guest of honor. Paul, our very gracious host. The little monkey, whose name I still don't know. And I, of course, am Pagan Min. You really don't remember me, do you? Your mother, she never spoke of me, never mentioned me. No. We'll change all that. Paul, I need cash.
How much do you need?
All of it. Thank you. Here we go. All right. With this, with the smile.
That's you.
That's me. Although I'm not so sure anymore. Now, your mother. Your mother, on the other hand, she understood me. She knew me in a way that no one ever did. That takes me back. The last time I saw Ishwari was years ago. She told me she loved me. Women, they can do that. They can tell you they love you in the moment and mean it. Men, on the other hand, no, men only really love you in hindsight. And too much distance has built up. So, when your mother decided to flee to the United States with you on her hip, I couldn't help but blame myself. Then I realized, it's not me. No. It was the fucking Golden Path. Those fucking terrorists, they ruin everything. Like dinner. Did no one ever teach you that it's rude to text at the table? Let's see it. Hit me. Boom. Really, guys? We're not checking for these anymore? Ah, I'm with Ajay Ghale. You'll love this part. Help. A text for help. You don't text for help, you cry for help. So come on, you're gonna cry for help. If you're gonna do something, you're gonna do it right. Here we go. Go on. Cry for help. Try for help.
Help?
Oh, pathetic. No, cry for help.
Help!
You mean it, boy.
Help!
Help! From your diaphragm!
Help!
Help! Shh, 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 shh. Now we listen. Nothing. I'm afraid they're not coming for you, buddy.
Oh!
We'll find out what he knows. Terrorists, right? Now, please, stay right here. Enjoy the crab rangoon. Don't move. I will be right back.
Okay.
Yuma, we need to talk.
So, I guess I could just chill out here. I don't know anything about this place. Pagan Min's obviously a little bit crazy, but he likes me and he knew my mother, so that's a solid plus. The Herc's return missions will become available once you complete the mission in Sermon on the Hunt Mount. I don't know what that means, but let's see what my FPS is like. With everything maxed out, I am actually going in between 50 to 60 FPS, and that's solid. That's relatively solid. I don't know how that's going to look on YouTube when I put it out at 1080p 60 FPS, and I'm getting like 50 FPS, but whatever. Alright, we're going to feed the top. So what's going on here anyways? I mean, this is a really nice place. Oh.
What the fuck?
Yeah, okay, what is this? RA memo, increase Golden Path activity. There has been a recent rise in Golden Path activities in the area surrounding Banapur. We have increased our presence at all southern border stations in response to the intercepted shipments of weapons and supplies, presumably destined for the Golden Path. All convoys and patrols should be on high alert for terrorist movements. So, I was being taken in through the border by the Golden Path. Does that make them slightly better guys? good guys? I don't know what's going on around here. I can't really say who's good or bad, and I've only been here for a bit. But the AJ, or not, no, I'm AJ. The other dude who was there, he was trying to help me, and he was like, I'm with AJ Ghale. So maybe I know the golden guys? The golden guns? Oh no. I just kind of want to chill out here for a little bit. What's on this? Rubber hose. Really? Okay. Ooh. 9,000 whatever's in there? Okay. But Pagan Min said I should stay here. And I wouldn't really want to piss off a crazy dude, so I think I'm just gonna chill out here. I'm not personally a fan of Crab Rangoon, though. Ooh, money. Right. Thank you! God. I'm a little bit sad about these monkeys, though. It would have been nice for them to be alive. I like monkeys. They're funny little things. They kind of remind me of me. Only sometimes, though. Other times, they're just like, eek! And then they show their fucking teeth at you, which means they're angry or scared. And for me, that's completely the opposite. And so, fuck them. Fuck monkeys. I don't even know if these are monkeys. They could be chimpanzee. I'm bad at ape identification. Except for orangutans. Alright, I'm just gonna chill out here. For a while.
Oh, fan-bloody-tastic. You, sir, are a gentleman. I sincerely apologize. We saw terrorists in the area and yada yada. The Crab Rangoon, right? It's... Fabulous. Well, come on, let's go.
All right, I didn't really eat your crab rangoon because I'm not a big fan of crabs, or I guess I don't know about rangoon. I've never had it, but I sat here for a while. But hey, it happens. Again, like you say, it had to do with the terrorists. And terrorists are bad.
3-point landing. You know, part of me is surprised your mother asked for you to bring her all the way back here. Thank you, Kamran.
You want me to follow?
Jesus Christ. Yes, boy, the ashes aren't going to scatter themselves. Did your mother ever tell you about your father?
Never know.
Mohan, the great protector of the Golden Path. He was a cunt. He hauled your mother out, sent her to spy on me. But we fell in love. We had a child. And that is when Mohan showed his true colors. He drove you and your mother away. Even killed your sister, Lakshmana. Which brings us here. Lakshmana shouldn't be alone anymore. I'm so glad we're finally back together. After you.
Oh, I had a little sister? That's sad. Alright, well, let's place our mom down. In loving memory of Lakshmana Min. Oh. Well, I got to do what I came here for. Place my mom down. What is this? Mohan Gale's journal. One more for next reward. Oh, neat. I don't know what that means, but let's get a move on.
Oh, good. You feel better now? Get it out of your system? Good. Maybe now we can finally shoot some goddamn guns.
Yeah, I agree! Let's go do that! Right? We're gonna go shoot terrorists? Save the- Oh, you're telling me I shouldn't have waited for Pagan Min?
Should I stay or should I go?
and that if I need to, if I want to actually play the rest of Far Cry 4, I should go against Pagan Min and probably save the dude who was being tortured for like 20 minutes straight.
Should I stay or should I go?
Okay, I can do that.
It's always tasty.